All right, the fabulous Susan Anton is here, and we're going to your opportunity to hang with her and her music live. But before we get to all that, and before we do the Baywatch obligatory reminiscence, you live in Las Vegas.
Live in Las Vegas.
So when he does these temperatures.
Oh, yeah, the 80, 90, this is nothing.
Yeah.
There are a bunch of wussies here. We're like 112.
And is it fun and great to live there, or is it 112 and I got to get out
of it? It's only 112 a couple months out of the year.
Right.
So for the most part, it's really pretty fantastic.
Yeah.
And cost of living, you can't beat it.
Right, people talk about that.
Sure.
Yeah, it's pretty sweet. So, and we built a production studio there, my husband and I. And
oh, wow.
I just love being at the news desk.
Sure.
I feel so smart and intelligent.
Well, Let's talk about things. It's an illusion. We will talk about things. When the feature film came out, everybody, Baywatch, Baywatch, Baywatch. You did it for 4 years?
The series, yeah, I did the series for 4 years. I played a mother. I have to tell everybody, that's not me.
Me, no, that's Gina Lee.
That's, yeah, but I wouldn't mind being that.
Yeah, right.
You know, that's perfectly acceptable.
Right.
Just put my head on that body.
I always forget how high cut those bathing suits were until you see it.
You know, well, I didn't have to wear those, thank God. I was a lifeguard's mother.
Uh-huh.
I played Summer's mother, Jackie Quinn. So
right.
I got to wear more respectable clothing and just say, swim, Summer, swim. Don't let that shark kick
you. Right. See, what great dialogue there. I didn't know. I mean, I knew you did music, but I didn't know that you were really involved with jazz.
Well, it's not jazz per se, though, you know, I am going to be at the Catalina Jazz Club for We Spark Cancer Support Center. But I've been singing my whole life. I toured with Kenny Rogers, toured with Frank Sinatra. You know, I've been singing forever. Mm. Go to my website and check out my music. It's fabulous. but I was talking with Jason Alexander in the green room, you know, and he's an amazing singer that people know now, but they didn't know for a long time.
Yeah.
You know, we're very talented people in this
industry.
We do many things.
Well, but I always think, we've just had this conversation here a couple times. Acting is great.
Yep.
Isn't singing the more intimate thing?
It is. You know, and what I love about these smaller clubs is because it is a return to, nowadays the arenas are so huge and so cavernous.
Yeah.
And it's all superstar driven, like, you know, Jennifer Lopez. But back in the day when I was coming up, you had these great, like, Ye Little Club in Beverly Hills.
I remember that place. Absolutely.
Right? And all these cool little places where you could go and just have these intimate evenings with people with a great little combo and very spontaneous. And so, you know, music, the music scene, it's a wonderful night, you know, to be able to get out and share song with people. And I think of it as just a musical monologue.
And this is a great group of people. Jeff Goldblum, Steve Tyrell, who, of course, has been here many times.
I love him.
And
do you guys sort of plan it out ahead of time, who's going to do
what? Well, you know, I'm going to find out more today. I'm going to our first rehearsal.
But great.
Jazz in the Cinema to raise funds for the We Spark Cancer Support Group. For everybody that's out there, go to the website, wespark.org, and come, because it is Jeff Goldblum, who you all know who Jeff Goldblum is. But he's an amazing jazz
player. I was going to say, he has this whole musical career that is not as widely known.
You know, and he's so suave.
Right.
You know, with his tie and his little hat.
He's very suave. That's so funny.
So it's going to be a really fun thing. And so it's open to the public. Check it out. Come and see. Support We Spark. But also August 25th and 26th, I'm going to be at Vitello's, upstairs at Vitello's, which is going to be really fun with my band of 35 years.
Wow. Huh.
So that's going to be, we're kind of, you know, yeah, we're getting older people. We've got stories to tell.
Right. You know the meatballs on the menu.
I know. So I know. Brad told me.
Yeah.
He said,
so please enjoy some of my meatballs.
Well, honey.
You could
a Saturday Night Live bit.
That's quite the request.
You could have the Frank Buckley meatballs open for you.
There you go. Have a little Frank Buckley
meatballs. Right.
And then come and hear a song.
There you go.
What a night.
Do you get nervous ever?
I'm nervous right now just sitting next to you.
Well, come on.
Not too much, not after all these years. I get excited, you know, and then once you just, it's like putting on a comfortable old pair of shoes or something, you get back out into what you do. You go like, oh, I remember this. Mm-hmm. This is great. And you realize, I learned a long time ago, that I was standing in the wings one night getting ready to go on at this big event. And I thought, you know, Susan, this is show business. This is not brain surgery. This is, everybody's going to be fine. If you forget a lyric or something doesn't go exactly as planned, those are really the moments that are the best. You know, I know that your previous guest is going to do Mamma Mia at the Hollywood Bowl, and I got to do Hairspray at the Hollywood Bowl. And I almost missed a cue, a very important cue. And I never ran so quickly from one end of the Hollywood Bowl to the other, because I was so busy watching this show going, oh, this is so
good. You were enjoying it.
Oh, my God, I'm on. You
know? Well, Susan will be on. Don't miss her. It's this Sunday, July 30th at the Catalina Jazz Club, 6 p.m. More information, as she mentioned. And it's a great organization.
Great organization.
WeSpot.org. and have a chance to support the We Spark Cancer Center.
Yeah.
Susan, nice to see you.
Yeah. Very good Thanks to see all of you. Thanks. Next time you need advice, you know.
Right.
Hey.
It's a time, but it's not impossible.
I know.